Danny. Welcome to the Meet the Brain series.
Thank you.
So, could you tell us, what's your research interest?
So, I study how the cerebral cortex develops.
And what's exciting about your field of research?
Well, this region is very sexy, the cortex, because it's the main source of our high cognitive skills, such as the intelligence.
Okay, and how do you reach your research goals?
So, I mainly work with mice. They have a very tiny brain, but with all the regions that we have. So it's a great tool to understanding how the brain develops.
Okay, cool. And who are your partners in your research?
So I work with several other labs across Europe, mainly from Germany and the UK.
And what are you most looking forward to?
So I want to understand how the cortex develops and all the folding that appears and is very important for humans, how this can happen during development.
And how can your research change the world?
So if we understand how the cortex develops, this will help us to understand the etiology of several brain disorders that have a very important developmental component.
Yeah, that'd be very important. What are the disciplines synergize well with your research?
So we study from the very basic molecules and how the neurons interact in order to develop the cortex, so different fields join together to understand all this very complex process.
Okay, cool. And does your research have real-world applications?
Well, this will help to open new strategies to treat several diseases that have as an origin in the cortex.
Okay, and what's next in your field of research?
Next, what we want to do is we want to model all the processes that happen during human development, but in other species like the mouse, to fully understand how this complex structure develops.
And who or what is your inspiration?
The main inspiration comes from the following question: why we are so intelligent compared to other mammal species?
And if you could have a coffee with a scientist from the past, who would it be?
So I will go with Rita Moltancini. So she was the first discovering neurotrophic factors. She was very hardworking and very inspirational for a lot of scientists.
That would be an amazing coffee to have. So what's the best thing that has happened in your career?
The best thing has been to being able to collaborate with different labs, joining forces to understand this complex process.
And how many countries have you visited during your research career?
Mainly through Europe.
And what would you say to your younger self when you were starting your scientific career?
That sometimes there are unexpected results that can be very important and can change the field of research.
And finally, what do you think will be the next big thing in neuroscience?
The next big thing will be to understand all the connections that happen between all the neurons in our brain. And this will help us to know how the brain works and try to, with that, treat different diseases.
Okay, thanks a lot, Danny.
Thank you.